S. Carter Brook. I.
Director.
Director L.K. Rachel Hannon. And assistant director, I can't see right now.
Just Navy saying. League sub of tenant, me! Introduction. HMCS Cornerbrook was a long-range hunter-killer submarine of the Royal Canadian Navy. She is the former Royal Navy Upholder class submarine HMS Ursula, purchased from the British at the end of the Cold War. She is the third boat of the Victoria class and is named after the city of Cornerbrook, Newfoundland. Here's a photo of HMCS Cornerbrook.
It's a very big submarine, as you can see.
Very large.
Subject matter, lol.
Subject matter.
The making of HMCS Cornerbrook. What was she used for? How old is she? Fun fact and a thank you. Here's another photo of Cornerbrook.
The making of Cornerbrook. On April 6, 1998, the Canadian government announced its decision to acquire the four Upholder class submarines from the United Kingdom, which had been placed in reserve by the Royal Navy when it switched to an all-nuclear submarine fleet in the early 1990s. All boats were renamed and the class designator was changed from Upholder to Victoria.
Operationally, Canadian Force submarines are a specialized element of Canadian Maritime Forces. They directly contribute on Canadian security in national defense through their ability to undertake lengthy covert patrols in Canadian maritime areas of responsibility and more distant waters. Such patrols frequently involve operations with national or allied forces or in support of other government departments. Another photo.
Here's another nice photo of it berthed alongside a jetty, and you can see in the background where the jetty is. HMCS Cornerbrook sign alongside there. What she was used for. In February 2008, Cornerbrook departed from Halifax during a snowstorm for a three-month deployment to the Caribbean Sea. As part of the deployment, the submarine operated with the United States Joint Intricacy Task Force South, which attempts to counter drug trafficking, people smuggling, and piracy in the region.
Here's another photo by the lighthouse. You can see right here. How old is she? She was first launched in the year of 1998. So, if you do the math, she would be, wow, she is 22 years young. Imagine that.
And this, I do believe that she's 22 years as of purchase from the United Kingdom, from Canada. Because obviously the Cold War was quite some time ago.
I wanted to do like a little, can you find it? But I circled the corner brook, if you can see it.
It kind of looks like one of the buildings just kind of floating along in the water.
Exactly.
Well done.
A fun fact about HMCS Corner Brook. Did you know in 2007, Corner Brook began a busy operational circle, including participation in the NATO exercise Noble Warrior. Thank you for listening.
Bravo, well done.
Awesome, good job.
Great job. Yes, that was fantastic.
Good.
Can I ask a silly question?
Sure.
Do they actually like travel like that with the above part, like out of the water, if they're not really hiding, or are they actually underwater when they're going?
Well, I think when they're hiding, they're usually underwater.
But if they're not hiding, like if they're just going, like can you just walk about on the top of it like that while it's moving?
Yes.
Like,
yeah, you can.
Oh.
You can. Usually when they're deployed, if they're coming in and out of harbor, they come, they surface. And once they're deployed on a mission and out of harbor, then they're underwater and gone incognito, I guess, or in secret. So undetectable, or so you'd say.
Also, Mike Rickards, your thoughts, Mike Rickards?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Because I put my headset on, I wasn't sure. It's a little bit of both. Because our submarines are diesel electric, meaning they run when submerged on a electric battery. They only have so long they can stay submerged before you have to recharge. But there's a thing called snorkeling. So they have a long snorkel that comes up out of the fin. And it's a big exhaust tube that floats on the surface. So they keep the submarine down and they put the little snorkel up. But the key to staying undetected is that you don't come to the surface, you stay under. So they generally try to always stay under the water. That being said, they also don't sail very well on the surface. They're designed to be underwater. So they bob like a cork and make everybody really sick when they're on the surface. And if you remember, when they first brought them over from England, there was the fire on the one, and that was because they were running on the surface with the hatch open, and they got water inside. So because of that, they always try and stay under.
Gotcha. I just can't believe they're walking on the top like that. Like, it's wild.
Oh, they're not big by submarine standards. They're pretty big. They have a crew of 50. And there's lots of room to walk on the top because they have non-skid.
That makes sense, yeah.
Also, if you're not wearing the right shoes and you don't slip, like it could be slippery on top of there, so I think it's dangerous.
What did you say, Mr. Rickards, about non-slip? Is it a certain material that they use, or is the submarine is made out of, or just a particular section on the top of the sub that they can walk?
It's just a section. Have you ever been on a sailboat? You know how if you fall, you skin your knee on that rough deck? Or in a swimming pool, if the stairs are painted, it's rough. It's the same thing. You put it down, You sprinkle salt or sand, silica sand, into the paint when it's wet. It becomes like sandpaper. That's non-skid.
Thank you, sir.
Awesome.